What is up? My name is now officially Gray Sky Vapor. I changed my name Cricket. I changed my name from Cricket, I must say, because it was kind of bland and I didn't really feel that way. But that's the last time, this is the last time I'm changing my name ever in social media or anything. I wanted to make this video because today is my birthday and I want to give a gift to you guys. So here it goes. This is Storm 4. Review. It's gonna be really painful. So again, we have Storm 4. I officially played Storm 4 now, and I gotta say, it's pretty awesome. Now there are some ups and downs, pros and cons in this game. Let's start out with story mode. Story mode, it was pretty freaking stupid, but also cool. The boss battles were really hard to do. They're really hard to face off in. They're really hard to get an S rank in story mode in this game. Almost every other game is easy to have a S rank in story mode, but it's really hard to get all S ranks. What I don't like is most story modes actually just anime screenshots, as we all know. That was kind of boring and stupid. I don't like it. I like the final Sasuke vs. Naruto fight. That was pretty freaking dope. I like how it has so much detail in this game. It's just like every artist's dream to look at this game and see that they've done so good with this game. I like how in the Naruto vs. Sasuke fight, as in the manga, they're walking to each other really slowly and they punch each other really slow and kicking and have secret factors to it. And it's just like, you have to have so much with this. This is why we had a delay for the game, because of this epic stuff. Like, it was so groundbreaking of the final fight. It took from all past history of their fights when they were little. I even liked the little kid, the little baby fight with each other. It was really cute and funny. I just like how through all the time they put so much effort into this last one. Out of all the bullcrap they put in this story mode, they actually did good with this one. I actually like it. And I gotta say, the mechanics of this game in story mode is awesome. It's just straight up wonderful. Let's go on to adventure mode. It's really doo-doo. I don't like it. It's boring. Only reason I like it is because I want to go do. I usually play it for like a little bit, for like a job for a while, or getting like character skins from the last previous Storm games. It's not that fun. It's really not fun at all. Wow, and adventure mode. It's like when you have adventure mode, you're like, wow, adventure mode. I'll pass. I like free battle. Free battle is fun. It's only fun for like if you got a person coming over to your house to play. And if you got like more than two people, you can have like league and tournament. I like survival for a little bit. It helps you like practice before you go online. But that's what online is for like player matches. Like, we'll get into that later. League is good for like customizing your character the way you want them to look like. We already had that before in this previous Storm games. It's not really, free battle is like something you would do when you're bored, you don't want to play online. Online battle. And the final thing, well, in the selection screen at least I'm going to cover. One line is kind of mediocre. I know everybody's thinking, Gray, what are you talking about? It's really bad. It's really a bunch of lag in the game. A lot. Revolution, we have serious lag in that game. But at least it's not like this. Compared to Revolution's network ability, Revolution looks like a king right now when it comes to internet connection. Has so much lag in the game. I played last night and it was like I had to freaking tap so hard on my fighting buttons. It was like I couldn't do anything in the game. It was like so late in the game. I could not play. It was hard to play the game. And people use it to an advantage. I think that's kind of stupid to use it as your advantage. Or just leave the game. And I really don't like that. That's pretty much it about actual badness of online play. Oh, no. I messed up just now. You can't spectate endless or tournament. Oh, my God. That is retarded. Why would you take that out of the game? We don't want to sit there and look at a stupid screen for like days, looking, wondering if the match will, if Endless Weave will keep going. It's really stupid. It's no fun. Why would you take that out of the game? We can't see how the player plays, which is kind of cool at first because like you don't want them to know how you play so they can't beat you so easily. But we want to look at it and see how good the match actually got or whatever, if it was intense and stuff. I like watching, I don't know about y'all, but I like watching people play Storm games. I do. Main person I like to watch is Sheikah's Clouds. That's pretty much it. But to sit there and just look at a dull screen, Naruto mean mugging the screen, I don't really want to watch that. And so, in my opinion, I think online battle, they could have did much better. For delay, they could have did much better with online battle. They could have done way much better. Now, I'm going to go to straight and simple. I'm going to talk about the mechanics of the game. When I tell you the mechanics of the game is the best, like, the best of all time, the Storm games, it is wonderful. You know, and I want to talk about the counterattack. You know how in the counterattack in Revolution, it will, like, make a noise in here? You barely can hear it. So it's unpredictable most of the time. In my opinion, they did so much better with counterattack. Actually, I like the counterattack also in Revolution. Not a lot of people like that. Matter of fact, a lot of people did not like that. But I did. And I love the counterattack in this game. I mean, almost every character in the game has a speed boost. What I mean by speed boost, Sakura is way faster. She has Sucky Taijutsu, but she is way faster than she is in any other Storm game. We all know Sakura is like the worst character to play with in any other Storm game. But in this game, you might actually win. Oh my God, don't tell me about Tag Team. That is so awesome. But a lot of people, when you go in, you know how you go into combo and keep going in and you're like switching your partner? It's really easy to spam that now. That's probably a downfall in the game. A lot of people will try to use that in the game. But honestly, I haven't seen a lot of people do that. Only if, like, you don't have any subs, they'll do it. As far as I'm knowing, because they only do that to me. And I tell you right now, Tag Team is, like, the most wonderful idea. I don't know why we didn't have it since Storm 2. I don't know why. Storm 2 is, like, the most wonderful game, in my opinion. But we're not talking about Storm 2. We're talking about Storm 4. Tag Team is so wonderful. I wish it would, like, stay in the game or whatever. Or any other game we'll ever have in Naruto. I'm pretty sure we'll have more. And I tell you, the character roster, it is so... delicious! I mean, this character roster is like the best thing ever. I mean, oh my God. It's like spaghetti with Parmesan cheese. A bowl of ramen with chopsticks. Pizza with pineapple and sausages. A $5 footlong. A brownie. I mean, the character roster is so freaking dope, but I'm still wondering, where are the support characters at? I don't know where they are. Me and my friend Christopher, we were talking about that last night. Where is the support characters at? I don't know if you have to buy them or, like, I know some of the characters are DLC, but, like, the actual support characters that we had since Storm 3, where are they at? I'm really shocked about that. I don't know where they at. I'm pretty sure that it's just, like, you probably gotta do more in the game or whatever. But I'm still wondering. That's pretty much it. That's only a downfall on roster. And I want to go to ranked. Ranked matches are pretty freaking awesome. I gotta say, my favorite character in that roster right now has to be Young Obito. What I'm gonna tell you, Young Obito is so freaking dope in this game. He's way faster than any other Storm game. He's so much faster. I love the intermill. Hold on, I gotta redo that. I like how in the elemental effects, that is like the best part of the game. You can take it off, but I wouldn't. It makes the game way more challenging to do. I really do. I like how all this stuff is coming together in the game. It was just really cool. Don't get me started on the rounds. I think that's actually fun, but the only thing downfall about it is that like if you're the one that won the actual round and you have lower health, really low health, it still falls in the next round. So it's pretty easy to be defeated right there unless you clutch out of that. That's pretty much it for the new features. I don't like in the selection screens where you can like choose story mode, adventure mode. It's Naruto, but like we always had Naruto in there, but like it's like he doesn't say anything anymore. Every other Storm game, he says something. I actually miss that. Man, like, don't get me wrong, I love the strong pose he does, because that's like kawaii. If you know what I mean. No homo. But like, I love the game so much that I would like eat it for breakfast. But that's all I think about the game. It's so freaking dope. It is like the best Storm game ever. When they mean the Storm, I'm telling you, there's no words that can explain how good this game is. No way at all can they explain this good. Well, that's it for me. I am, too much guys think, like, comment, subscribe, tell your friends about it, I got a Twitter, Facebook. Wait, no. No, I don't. You don't need to know that. You don't need to know that. Why? You don't need to know that. Anyway, I got a Twitter, Snapchat. Snapchat is still Cricket Deleter. I can't change that. I don't want to change it. My Vine is Gray Sky Vapor. My Instagram is Gray Sky Vapor. Pretty much the same as when I was deleted. So, tell me what you guys think. Like, comment, subscribe. And I will see you later.